Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Principal Update for Thursday, January 6th. Happy New Year to everybody. It is great to be back in school. And speaking of being back in school, that was the biggest decision that was made over Christmas break by the School Advisory Task Force that is based out of St. Albert the Great, our main campus school. And for those of you that are unaware, the School Advisory Task Force is comprised of 17 individuals. And this is, you know, parish leaders, school leaders, parents, current parents, former parents. There's several physicians on the task force as well that take in information from many, many different sources, and they make informed decisions based on that information for the operation of both of our campuses, the St. Upper the Great campus, as well as St. Upper the Great at Assumption Academy. And the decision that was made was to come back to in-person learning. So here we are, we're 4 days in already, and really, you know, I think both of our campuses do a wonderful job of the remote learning. We have the swivel system, especially compared to what other schools have out there, where it might just be like a webcam put at the back of the classroom where it might be hard to hear or hard to see the board. Our swivel cameras and everything, you know, they're not perfect, but they do an okay job. But even that, it hails into comparison for what it's like to truly be back in the classroom and to be learning from our exceptional teachers. So the decision to come back in person was the priority. Right after that was about the masking or not masking, and the decision was unanimous from the task force to mandate masking through January and then to revisit that going forward. And really that decision is based on the fact that since we're in person, we want to make sure that we're protecting the individuals that are doing the teaching, that is the teachers and the staff. So we kind of have, you know, many layers of protection. So we have like the hand sanitizing as a layer, the distancing, the masking, the extra cleaning, the extra sanitizing, the air purification, the windows open, the doors cracked. So all these different layers are, you know, compounded together. And the more layers that we have, the less likely it is for that virus to reach our students and staff. So, you know, I know that masking is kind of a hot button issue, but that's just like one layer that we added just to keep our faculty staff. And to be honest, our substitute teaching pool, and this isn't just, you know, Assumption's not alone with this. Substitute teachers are very hard to come by, and not only, you know, here, but in the state of Ohio and all across the United States. There's less and less people that are willing to come and step into a school during the pandemic. So if a certain number of our staff members come down and are ill and are out, then we're forced to go into remote learning, which we don't want to do because that's not the best place for the kids. So really all of these protocols are in place to ensure that our kids are in school learning where they are getting the best education that we can deliver. So that being said, we are looking forward to Catholic Schools Week coming up. Some of these events are going to be modified. So in next week's newsletter, you'll see the daily list of what's going to be going on. The Parent Corps calendar, I think at the end of this newsletter, has a little brief overview of what's happening on those days. But we are looking at events, one event at a time in particular, going through them and deciding, you know, is this something that we can go forward with? How can we modify it? Or does it have to get postponed until later in the school year? So some events are being postponed, like the father-daughter dance. I'm not saying we're canceling it altogether. We're just going to not have it in February. We'll just push it back to like maybe April or when it's a little bit nicer outside. So, you know, I do appreciate you, you know, being patient and walking through with us as we navigate the pandemic, but I think we've been doing an excellent job so far together. A reminder that we are really recommending having either the cloth mask or the N95 or KN95 masks and not having the gaiters or the cloth ones. It's really the surgical ones or the N95s that we want to have. Making sure that students are washing their hands and sanitizing, and we're doing our best we can to distance them and to make sure that they're safe while they're here. And again, we ask for your support in keeping all of your students home if somebody is sick in the family, at least for a day until we can make sure that sickness is not COVID related. That's another protocol that we have in place. I know that this is starting to wear on many of you, and there's a lot of policy changes, and the CDC comes out with something one day. Keep in mind, we follow the CDC, the Ohio Department of Health, and the Cuyahoga County Board of Health, and that COVID Advisory Task Force takes in all that information to make the recommendations for the school. So there's a lot of different information coming in from different sources. You know, and just really, I'm appreciative of all the parents being supportive and, you know, patient with us as we navigate this. But we are in person, and that's the most important thing, that we stay in-person learning. So until next week, thank you for all of your support and your understanding, and make sure you continue to pray for the safety of all the staff and students, and we will do the same for you and your family. Thank you, and God bless.